Here we go, trying to get around the problems of technology here. Hopefully this will work. It seems like every time I try to get someone else to say what needs to be said, I get into trouble. It's always been the way. So if I say it myself, it's okay. If I start looking for somebody else to be adamant and say it, very negative things happen. So I guess I'll just have to keep saying it for now. Another affirmation came up today, which is tremendously profound. It's the most advanced one yet. Yesterday, we had a very advanced one, which is, my spirit is not in competition with time. And then today, the next one came, which was, my spirit doesn't need any help. My spirit does not need any help. My spirit does not need help from time. My spirit doesn't need to help time. My spirit doesn't need to help time. My spirit doesn't need any help from time. Okay, my spirit has never needed any help from time. My spirit will never need any help from time. My spirit doesn't need any help from time. My spirit will never need it to help time. My spirit doesn't need any help at all. My spirit has never needed help. Did God create something that needed help, that was incomplete, that was weak, that was feeble, that was vulnerable, crippled, tired, separated, alone, needy? Did God create something which is needy? The answer is no, not at all. We don't need any help. What we are doesn't need any help at all. It is time that wants spirit to help time perpetuate itself. And so time does that by saying that it's helping spirit. It turns it around, projects on spirit, says, no, spirit, I'm helping you. But what time really wants to do is help spirit maintain time. That's what time wants to do. It gets a little confusing to see things exactly as they are. We can certainly do that, but what more important is to state facts. The spiritual path is really about stating facts. My spirit does not need any help, has never needed any help. This sense of neediness that we have comes entirely from time. Time is projecting all of this as if it's something very important for spirit to pay attention to. It's not. There's nothing in time that's important to pay attention to. Absolutely nothing in time that's important to pay attention to. Spirit is not needy. You see, time is defending against total mental chaos, so spirit can hope, can at least entertain the notion that it can someday somehow become prime creator. And time says to spirit, hey spirit, if time doesn't keep defending against this mental chaos, you will experience total mental chaos. Well, that is only true if spirit insists on keeping the idea of wanting to be prime creator. It's only a fact, but the overriding fact is spirit can change its desire, what it wants to experience, and choose to experience itself as spirit and not as trying to become something that it's not. And then there's no mental chaos and there's no need for time to defend against it. So, but time, its job is presenting this idea in a spirit of wanting to be prime creator is to say, hey spirit, you need me, you need time. If you don't have time, you're going to suffer annihilation. That's what time is telling spirit. So spirit says, you need, time is saying, spirit, you need help to sustain time. See, spirit is sustaining time by choosing the idea of wanting to be prime creator. That sustains time. That's what sustains it. And so mind says to spirit, spirit, you got to keep sustaining it, and you need help to keep sustaining it. Help from time and all the deceptions and tricks, etc. Well, that is factual. It's a limited fact. In that it's leaving out the full story. What spirit really needs is help in realizing it doesn't need any help. Spirit doesn't need any help from time at all. Spirit is complete, absolutely complete, and it can choose a new idea. It doesn't need help from time to choose a new idea at all. Spirit is not needy. Time is needy. Time is constantly needy. Okay. And time's, it needs to perpetuate itself. It needs to keep going. It needs to have this graduated loss to defend against mental chaos. So, for spirit to say, I don't need any help, is absolutely true. That is simply stating a fact, a spiritual fact. Spirit does not need any help. How could spirit be needing help? For what? To do what? To do what? What does spirit need help to do? To be what it is? To function as it was created? Doesn't need any help for that. So the only thing that spirit supposedly needs help for is to perpetuate time. And of course spirit really doesn't want to perpetuate time. And time is insisting that, hey spirit, you need help, you need to be helped, you're struggling with this, you have a hard time perpetuating time. No, it doesn't. It's automatic. It just shows the idea of mind be prime creator. Automatically all this arises. And the defense of time will always arise, and time will always insist that spirit it needs help, that's needy. It's time that's needy. Time does not want to realize how vulnerable it is, how weak it is, what a house of cards it is. And so it wants the spirit to think that it's needy. Spirit is not needy, so we say, I don't have any needs. I don't need any help. I don't need any help. I don't have any needs. What you're stating is that you are complete, and you are not feeble or weak or anything, that you are absolutely complete and totally self-sufficient as you are. Your being is entirely complete. Always has been, always will be. So whenever you try to teach, time says, hey, you need help. You see that? Oh, you need help. You're needy. Oh, you obviously need help. You must need help. So if you try to deliver the message of spirit, time will say, oh, that's great, but I need help. You need help. I need to help you. See, you're needy. You're not complete. It's actually time that wants to help. It wants to be sustained. Thinking that the alternative is mental chaos for spirit. Well, when spirit gets a taste of mental chaos, it says, oh, I don't want this idea, I'm going to choose a different idea. So time is just a way to perpetuate this crazy whim of wanting to be prime creator, actually. So as soon as you start feeling needy, that you need help, you draw into your life time worshippers. That's what happened to me yesterday, as a matter of fact. I was feeling like maybe I need some help to get this message out, and then immediately a time worshipper showed up. It was amazing. And I said, no. You know, it's like, I feel like, okay, I got to do it. Because time, as soon as spirit asks for help, time shows up. What else can show up? What else can show up? You know, we're so used to praying for help. That is like the worst habit we have, actually. It really is. If you want to get right to the root of the situation, that is the worst habit we have, praying for help. We say, prayer, oh God, or whatever we pray to, we say, please help me, please, I need your help so desperately, I need help, help, help. That is the prayer of time. That is a prayer of delusion. That is the wrong prayer. It's upside down and backwards. What we really need to pray is affirm and say, God, I don't need any help. Thank you for helping me realize I don't need any help. All I need to realize is I don't need any help. And so the prayer should be, instead of saying, God, I'm so miserable and vulnerable, and I've got so many problems, and oh, it's terrible, please help me, won't you help me, we're so desperate. That's all wrong. That's the wrong prayer. The right prayer is to say, God, what I am doesn't need any help, and I accept that. I accept that what I am doesn't need the slightest bit of help. In other words, it's saying, I accept myself as you created me. That is the right prayer. I accept myself as God created me, which is that which doesn't need any help whatsoever. That is prayer. The other stuff is the opposite. It only strengthens delusion. It strengthens your attachment to time. Which is why I've never gotten answers to my prayers. God always says, what are you praying for? You don't need any help. I say, no, God, I need a lot of help. God says, no, you don't. You just think you do. Time is telling you you need help, but you know you really don't, which is true. I remember when I was young, I didn't want any help from anyone. I said, I don't need any help. I'm perfectly competent, and I feel perfectly competent, but the world insists on helping you. It says, oh, no, let me help you to hurt you. In other words, time says, oh, no, spirit, you need help. I said, no, I'm spirit. And they said, yeah, but you need help, so let us help you. That's time saying that. So again, the right prayer is to affirm that you are what as God created you, which is you don't need any help at all. Absolutely none. You're not vulnerable, you're not needy, you're not suffering any sort of feebleness or incompetence or anything like that. It's impossible you could ever need help in any way. Again, when you pray, say you affirm what you are. Affirm the facts of your true identity, your true being. Thank you, God, for reassuring me that I don't need any help. And of course, when you affirm that you don't need any help, what happens? Your troubles start to dissipate and go away, right? Because you're attracting, when you say, I need help, you're attracting problems. That's how you attract problems, is by claiming that you need help. Now, case in point, before I came here, I was in spirit, and I felt all these cries from somewhere, and I sort of localized them on this planet, and they're saying, help, help, please, we need help. The overwhelming cry was coming from this planet. We're trapped, we need help, we're so desperate, we need help, 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 help. And I said, oh, I need to help those people. Well, that's the trap. That is the trap. The fact is, nobody needs any help. What the world needs is help to affirm that they don't need any help. Each one of us needs to affirm we don't need any help at all. So all these constant prayers that we need help, that itself is the problem. That itself is the problem. Praying that you need help is the problem. So this completely turns things upside down. It's another total game changer, which is necessary right now. Anything that is not a game changer right now, you should just say, hey, not now. I need a game changer right now. This is a game changer. It's our very asking for help, which is the problem. We need to, instead of asking for help, we need to affirm we don't need any help. And that aligns us with our true being, and then problems vanish. They'll vanish for us. Our problems only arise in time because we're saying, oh no, we need help, we need help, we need help. In other words, we need time. Time arises in an imagined gap between cause and effect. To help out, to keep effect from being experienced simultaneously with cause. In other words, to help that situation out. But there is no gap. There is no gap. There's no place for time to help out, to intervene. There's no time for any separation, intervening, or anything like that whatsoever. So, again, we're turning things 180 degrees around, saying, instead of saying, God, help me, help me, help me, saying, God, don't help me. I don't need any help whatsoever. I don't need any help whatsoever. That ascends you. That is ascension right there. If you want to ascend, that is ascension. You ascend out of all those who are screaming for help. Because what screaming for help means, give me more time. Please, God, give me more time. Please perpetuate time. If we don't perpetuate time, I'm going to be annihilated. Please perpetuate time. Help me become more happy and loving so I can be more reconciled unto time. All of that. That's all delusion. That's all entirely delusion. We're praying for more time. They'll say, God, I don't need any time. My spirit is not in competition with time. I don't need any help from time. And I don't need to help time in any way. I don't need time at all. I don't need time. Affirm that. Say, God, I don't need any help. I don't need any help. And you will ascend into a situation where there is no need or call for help whatsoever. You will find that. Whereas those who are screaming for help, 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 they find themselves sinking down more, further and further and further into terrible situations, which justify their screaming for more help. That's the delusion of time. So we say, God, I don't need any help. Help me affirm. Help me affirm, God, that I don't need any help. Not a paradox. The real spiritual teachers will tell you don't need any help. No one needs help. There's nothing God created that needs any help whatsoever. None. Not at all. And just affirm that. Just state it. State the truth. State the truth. I don't need any help. I don't need any help. I've never needed any help. Ah. heard you. I knew I heard cat, all sorts of stuff's going on out here. And outside in the dark. So, this is a game changer, and I've been using it today. It just came up to my attention this morning as I was praying and meditating on a big problem that arose in my life suddenly. If somebody trying to help me, which I could tell is a very dangerous situation indeed. They're only pretending to want to help. Not any of the viewers here, by the way. It's something else that came in uninvited into my life, as it were. Tried to push into my life, and I said, whoa, this isn't good at all. And I could tell that it's not a good situation, to say the least. Very dangerous situation. And it's because I must have had a slight vibe of like, hey, maybe I need some help. And they actually offered to help. I said, no, I don't think so. I'm having to reaffirm this now. And then I said, well, how do I deal with this situation? How do I deal with it? By saying, I don't need any help. I don't need any help at all. Very different. We're used to praying for money. God, please give me some money. God, please give me a house. Please give me friends. Give me this. Please, I'm so needy. I'm so desperate. That's all wrong. That's all backwards. That makes it worse. Instead of praying for anything, don't pray for anything. Just assert, hey, God, I don't need anything. I don't need anything. God, I'm exactly as you created me. I have absolutely no needs whatsoever. That is the right prayer. I don't need any help from time. I never need help from time. I will never need help from time. And I don't need to help time. And I never need to help time. I don't need any help from anywhere. Absolutely don't need any help whatsoever. I am as God created me. I don't have any needs. I am as God created me. I don't have any needs. So I keep looking for somebody to say this stuff because I feel like, you know, who am I to say these things? And I look on YouTube and I see all this stuff and there's nothing like it. There's nobody saying that. And I wish there were. I wish there were so many. But it's exasperating, and I can't just keep waiting around for someone to say it. I don't have any needs. Never have had any needs, and I never will have any needs. I don't have any needs, never have had any needs, never will. What does that ascend you into? You're ascending into your light body. You're ascending into the higher realms, fifth dimension, death-free realms. You are aligning yourselves with that by saying that, because there's no needs there at all. There's no needs there at all. There is just the total bliss of non-judgment and oneness. And it's, we can't even describe it. We won't worry about just trying to describe it. We'll stick with the affirmation. I don't have any needs. I am as God created me. I have absolutely no needs whatsoever. And don't get into, well, I need to love. I need to do this. No. That's a slippery slope going ahead. You have no needs whatsoever. Because time wants to be loved. When you talk about love here, it means time is talking. Time says it wants to be loved. It wants spirit to love time, to perpetuate time. That's what it's talking about. So forget about trying to outsmart yourself that way. Just say, I don't have any needs. I do not need any help whatsoever. I do not need any help whatsoever. And this is a shocker. This shocks your ego. The time-based meditation, time-based belief system, delusion, sleep, okay? It shocks it. It's like, oh, whoa. This is different. It catches it off guard. And this is what you know. This is what you want. It's like, huh? It doesn't know what do we mean. I don't have any needs. Maybe that was the cat, too. I don't have any needs. I don't need any help whatsoever. I don't need any help whatsoever. I have no needs. Now, to time-based way of thinking, this is blasphemy. It freaks it out. But if you have been on the spiritual path, you might be able to catch the breeze, set your sail up and catch this breeze. You know, say, hey, this is a game changer. You can recognize it. This is a game changer. You say, wow, this is certainly different. This completely reverses, doesn't it? It's a complete reversal. And you might be thinking, praying, saying, God, I really need a reversal. And the reversal is to say, I don't have any needs whatsoever. I don't need any help. That is the reversal. It's the reversal from saying, oh, please God, I need help, I need help, I need help. It is the reversal. 180 degrees, isn't it? I don't need anything. I don't need any help whatsoever. I don't need anything. I don't need help from time. I don't need help from anywhere whatsoever. I am as I was created. I always will be as I am was created. I am created perfect, flawless, one with all of reality. I don't have any needs whatsoever. I am what I am. I am what I am. I have no needs. I don't need any help whatsoever. I will never need any help. I don't need help from time. I don't need to help time. Okay. I'm not in competition with time in any way. Because I have no needs. I don't need to win. I don't need to lose. I have no needs. I don't need help. Now, of course, this one is like, oh, I don't know if it's the last one or not, but it's got to be close, because it is, you're sitting here with all your problems, and look, God knows I have a ton of problems right now. And it seems like absolutely crazy to say that, like, I don't need any help. But all these problems, the root of all these problems is the desire for help. That is the root. That is the root. It is the desire to help time perpetuate itself, keep going, you see, so that spirit can keep the idea alive of being prime creator eventually at some point. Keep it as a way of keeping it alive. But spirit really doesn't need to become prime creator. See, it's not a need whatsoever. It's a completely imaginary desire and need. As you sit here with all your problems in every which way, right? I mean, if I had to do a list, I don't know, I could write a whole book of all the problems I have right now. It's just, but all coming from desire for help, praying for help, saying that you, asking for help, that you have, you need to be helped, you're needy. All this stuff arises to support this notion, this delusion that you need help. So when you say, I don't need any help, you might think, oh my God, I'm going to lose whatever help is coming to me. So it's not an easy one necessarily to say. But keep in mind that as you affirm you don't need help, your problems will vanish like mist. Because they're only there to support this delusion that you need help. Because if you go to God and say, hey God, I need help, and you don't have any problems, like God says, really? You need help? And you look around and say, oh, maybe I don't. But if you've got all these problems, you say, God, I need help, look at me, I'm so wretched, I need help, 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 help. And we think, well, how can I, if this must be true, that what I'm saying, because look at all the problems I have. So we really attract all the problems to justify our insisting that we're needy, we need help. In other words, we're not as God created us, right? Because God didn't create us as needing help. So we're saying to God, hey God, I'm different, I've changed. See, I'm no longer what you created. I'm something else, meaning I'm not under, you didn't create me. And therefore I can be my prime creator. I can change reality, because look how needy I am, look how much help I need. So, even though it seems like this is like scary to say this, don't be scared at all. I've been doing it today, it's no problem, there's no problem. You just say, God, I don't need help. I really don't need any help. I don't have any needs whatsoever. I don't need to help anyone either, because there is nobody that needs help. There's nothing that needs help. There's nothing that God created that needs any help whatsoever. Absolutely not. So this is a real spiritual practice, not the fake kind that only generates more and more embracing of time and the notion of help, helping reality out, meaning not having cause and effect be simultaneous, but separated, and then have something in the interim or prior to the effect being experienced, prior to that, there's all this time, which is how we defend against mental chaos, which is the instantaneous effect of mind, of spirit wanting to be prime creator. It's the instantaneous effect. And we say, whoa, before that instantaneous effect, there's time, you see. And so we need help to keep time going. So we say, God, we need help. We need help, God, to keep time going. It's really difficult. You don't want us to be annihilated, do you? And God says, just choose a new idea. Just choose a new idea. What's the problem? You don't need any help. That's natural for you to choose ideas. Just be the way I created you to be. You're not needy. You don't have any needs other than to choose a new idea. But that's not the function normally, which is not a need really. Can't really define it as a need. It's what we are. It's how we were created. So again, this is real spiritual talk. And you just don't hear it. I wish I did. But the Holy Spirit, through prayer, brings this up to my attention. And I'm like, huh? I don't need any help. What? He's like, are you kidding? I need a ton of help. Holy Spirit says, no. Just say, I don't need any help. Trust me, I don't need any help. So I've been working on it today. And I'm kind of like, well, it makes sense, doesn't it? If you think it through, reason says, that's spot on. It's spot on. It's absolutely spot on. So when you come into a world that screams for help, the only help you can give it is to help the world see it doesn't need any help. No one needs any help. Of course, everyone says, look at this mess. Of course we need help. No, we don't need any help. What we are doesn't need any help. Let me ask you this. Does the dreamer need help from the dream? Really? Is the dreamer the one needs help? You have this dream. There's all these problems in the dream. Does the dreamer really need help? Not at all. Not at all. Only in the context of the dream does help have any meaning whatsoever. The dreamer doesn't need any help. Dreamer's not needy. Not needy at all. Doesn't need any help. So it's like that. We think all this stuff needs help. The world, we got to heal this, heal. Nothing needs to be healed. Nothing needs to be healed. Nothing needs any help at all. Everything is exactly as God created it. Exactly. We're just dreaming that prior to it being as God created it, it's something else, and that something else needs help to be perpetuated. This impermanence of that which is not yet complete. We think all this stuff is gradual loss, incompleteness, and we think we got to keep this incompleteness going. We got to fix it. We got to heal. We got to do something. We need help. Now we don't. We don't need help to dress up any dream in any way. The dreamer is not affected by the dream. What we are is not affected by this dream of incompleteness. Not at all. Reality is not affected. Reality doesn't need help. How could reality need any help? From where? From where does reality need any help? So, the sickness of this world is the feeling that we need help. That is the real sickness. One moment, please. I've got to put the garbage out tonight, don't I? Oh my gosh. See, well, you know, we do have to keep up appearances here. Even as we're here telling everybody, nobody needs any help. So we assume there's all this destructivity and all this stuff, and we got to stop doing it. We got to be enlightened. We got to blah, 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 blah. It's not true at all. We just need to accept ourselves as we all really are, which is we're not needy at all. We don't need any help. We've never caused any damage or destruction to anything. It's totally a dream, made-up dream, that somehow we caused some destructivity, that there's been some destructivity to what God created. Totally untrue. Totally untrue. People talk about the planet. We've harmed the planet so much, blah, 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 blah. What God created cannot be harmed in the slightest bit. Never can be. And there's nothing real that God didn't create. Okay. So God created the real, and there's nothing else. We're just imagining that there's something else. And this something else is vulnerable to all sorts of problems and destructivity and harm. And we're thinking that we need help to heal this, help to heal this. We got to heal people. We got to heal the earth. We got to heal all the life form, blah, blah, blah. No, we don't. We don't have to do anything. It's just a dream. It's just a dream of time. And we have to realize that it is just a dream. And what we are doesn't need any help at all. And this dream doesn't need any help. Does the dreamer need to help the dream out? Is the question. When you're dreaming and you have this dream, does the dreamer say, oh my gosh, I got to help out this dream. There's all these problems. I got to help. No, the dreamer just has to wake up. Just has to wake up. Nothing needs to be helped. Nothing real needs to be helped. And only the real is real. Nothing else exists. Except a mad whim that there's some precursor to reality. See, there is no precursor to reality. It's all our imagination. We're simply imagining it. And we're saying, God, help us with our imagination. We need help, 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 help. God says, no, you don't need help. You just need to choose a new idea. All right? You don't need help with your imagination. You simply need to choose a new idea. So you're not needy. You're not needy at all. The dream is needy, but you're not needy. And you don't need the dream. All right? You do not need the dream. And it gets very confusing when you listen to other spiritual teaching. I get confused, or I get disgusted. I just don't. There's lots of nice words there and concepts about love and blah blah blah, but let's get down to the reality of it, with the facts of it, which is, I don't need anything. I don't need any help. That's a fact. That's a fact. And that's the fact that needs to be emphasized, because this entire situation here is a bunch of need junkies. Pray, pray, pray. I need to do this. I need this. I need to heal this. I need to do this. You don't need to heal anything. There's nothing that needs to be healed. Did God create something that needs to be healed? Absolutely not. What God created, can it harm itself? Absolutely not. So how could there possibly be need for any healing? There isn't. There is no need for healing. The more you claim there's a need for healing, the more you attract dreams of sickness to yourself. The more you want to overcome something, the more you attract obstacles to yourself. Dream obstacles, of course. Time-based. The more time-based you become, more time-based, and all these problems surround you. So the people said, come here, help us, help, help, help. And I said, oh, I'll help out. What kind of help do you need? And it's endless. It's an unenlightened position to come to this world to try to help. That's not the answer. Nothing needs to be helped. So you come here, the true enlightened ones come here and just remind us, we don't need any help. What are you screaming for help for? You don't need any help. You're just like me. You're just like me. You're just trying to dream there's something prior to what you are. And you need to help in keeping that going, because you think if you don't keep it going, what you are will never come into being. If you don't keep the background story prior to what you are, that somehow then what you are will never become, because it's the result of the past. It is not the result of the past. What we are is not the result of any past. Not the result of any past whatsoever. So, I can say this stuff, but how do you... You know, can you get people to listen? I don't know. Can you lead a horse to water? Can you make a horse drink? I don't know. We'll find out, because I am saying this stuff. It'd be nice to get somebody else to say it, because it's so unbelievable, isn't it? That you don't have any needs whatsoever. You don't need any help. That seems like the most unbelievable thing you've ever heard. But I'm able to say it. Because it's true. It's true. It's not difficult to speak truth. But... You know, who will listen to truth here? Because everyone thinks, no, I need a past. I'm working on my past. Does reality have a past? No, it doesn't. So what are we working on? Our past. We're simply trying to find a way to avoid this feeling of annihilation when we choose the idea of wanting to be prime creator, which would try, in other words, change reality, which would annihilate reality. Mind presents that to us as total mental chaos, and we're trying to avoid that by saying, oh, well, prior to effects, cause and effect, there's something before that, which is time. So we're not experiencing this total mental chaos. We're experiencing gradual loss in time. It's just a dream, just made up. So just stating facts that cause and effect are not separate. As long as we want to be prime creator, the instant effect of that is always going to be total mental chaos. Okay, and then we can try to separate from reality in time, so to speak, prior to reality. The separation would be trying to be prior to reality. Precursors are a gap between cause and effect. That's another way of saying it too. But it's all simply make-believe. It's all simply make-believe. We have make-believe needs, make-believe help, all this stuff. If you want to get into trouble, just try to help somebody. Or just come across somebody who's needy. Say, oh, I need help. Can you help me? Or let's help, help, help. Then you really get into trouble then. Really get into trouble. Where are the teachers are saying the truth? Saying, I don't need any help. You don't need any help. Nobody needs any help. No one has ever needed any help. Nothing that God has created has ever needed the slightest bit of help. Where are those teachers? You see, that's what I want to find, you know. I want to find. Well, they say, be what you want to find. You know, that's, so, I guess, I don't know, it seems like we do have to do that, but gosh, certainly would be nice to for everybody to just have more and more reinforcement of this, but, you know, we do what we can. Cannot hand it over to somebody else who does have no idea of this, because it's not something that is easily handed over to somebody else at all. I mean, if you don't hear anybody saying this in the world, how do you just easily hand it over to somebody? Oh, here, and entrust them, saying, here, I'm sure you're going to teach the truth and be adamant about this and insist that you don't need any help at all, and nobody needs any help. How well do you think they do at that? So that's the problem. If you think about trying to teach truly in this world, and how do you keep the lineage going, who's going to, you know, fill the shoes of saying this type of adamant teaching and being absolutely serious about it and adamant about it? Now they're going to waver, you know, someone will say, of course, well, what about this? Surely they need help, or surely that needs help, etc., etc., etc. No, the fact is that the troubles that people experience are because they are praying for help. They're praying, they have need, they're praying needy, they're trying to perpetuate time. That attracts troubles. It attracts the intensity of time to them. And that, of course, causes loss, trauma and loss, and all the gradual loss of time. Time is just this total perpetual sacrifice. So, of course, you're saying, oh my gosh, this is terrible. Look at all the terrible stuff happening in the world. And you know, every time we try to turn towards the spiritual path, some horrible story, the news will push up some horrible story. It is like clockwork. I've noticed that over many, many years, prior to my trying to bring something out in the world, a story suddenly pops up like that, and it's exact blocks it. It's a perfect blocker. It's like time is blocking, trying to block truth coming into the world being spoken here. It is absolutely like that. So again, you have all these horror stories of these poor innocent people being traumatized, so terrible, you know, and all this. And people say, "Oh my God, we need to help them," and all this stuff. And nobody ever that diverts everyone's attention away from truth. That's time. Time is vicious, absolutely vicious in how it works, relentless. So who's going to say that stuff in the face of all this, you know, terrible things happening to you? How can you say such a thing? Have you no heart? Have you no heart? See, though, the way people talk about heart, it means to accept the fact that the neediness and help, need for help in the world, that's supposedly heart. That's not heart at all. That's delusion. Okay. What people need to hear is that nobody needs any help. No one's ever needed any help. What we are has never needed any help. No one, no exception of that. No exception. That's the current of bliss in the world. That's true heart. That is, true heart is actually bliss. The bliss of knowing that nobody needs any help and never will need any help. No one is needy whatsoever and will never be needy. Everyone is exactly as God created them. Everyone. That's the current of bliss. That is the transmission of truth into the world. So this song and dance that the news plays, you know, the world is it's non-stop. It is non-stop. All these variations. Constantly variation of the news, and every, you know, day there's some new big story, some horror story breaking in the world that's tugging on your heartstrings, and say, oh my gosh, those poor people, they couldn't help themselves, they needed help, so desperately needed help. People need help, so desperately need help. And it's so cruel and callous to suggest otherwise. Not really, not really. The only help we need is to realize we don't need help. And we do need that help, big time. We do need help to realize, to be reminded that we don't need any help. That is needed. That is the only thing that's needed in this world. The only help that's needed in this world is to be reminded we don't need any help. That's it. Because as we recall this and assert it, all the staging that we've used of time. We say, hey, I don't need you, time. I don't need you. I don't need you at all. And it's, but I can use my imagination to imagine that I don't need you. You see, I say, oh, you're there, and say, oh, that reminds me that I don't need you at all. That reminds me. You can use your imagination. You don't have to, it doesn't have to vanish for you, but you can have an overlay of all this stuff, this dance of sacrifice, and say, ah, I don't need any help from that whatsoever. I'm complete within myself. I'm totally complete. Because reality is always one. There's no incompletion in reality. There's no dependency in reality. That reality is not some codependent situation. Not at all. Everything is complete and whole eternally in reality. And there's just this, just like a blissful celebration, really. Reality is just this blissful celebration. And beyond what we can possibly imagine here. So it's fruitless to try and imagine it, really. Very much fruitless. So, people, you know, listening to this, the listeners might say, yes, but I can't possibly teach that. So how does it help me? Or what people, when people ask questions, what they really mean is, yes, I understand what you're saying, but how do I deal with this when people, you know, when I try to teach this and people come at me, you know, they want to know, how do I deal with this, you know? Right? That's really what the question is. That's how I always feel that the questions are all about. People say, yeah, but boy, people are going to come at me. When I say this, they're really going to come at me. Well, how can I possibly, you know, handle that? I don't know. I don't really don't know. It's not like I'm broadcasting this to all the people in my life or anything like that, because they think you're nuts when you don't need any help. So, I would say that each person is different in that situation, and it is simply, you need to practice in your own mind this. You don't need to broadcast it to the world necessarily. No, not necessarily. It takes a lot of determination and nerve to do this, built up over a long effort. It is not necessarily something that you can easily do as far as telling everybody, hey, nobody needs any help whatsoever. I wouldn't recommend trying that, okay? So don't think that you have to run out there and broadcast that or something. For me, I'm taking on the responsibility of saying this, starting the ball rolling, and we'll see what happens. But it's, of course, people will look at you like, wow, you know, you're terrible, you're crazy, you're terrible, what is it, or something. It's just like, this is not acceptable. Because we need to perpetuate time. What do you mean? We need to perpetuate neediness. Time is very needy. It needs to intervene. It needs to find out a way to intervene between cause and effect. So time has this insatiable need to figure out how to intervene and how to be permanent. And so it's constantly needy. It's incomplete. It says, I need to know how to be complete, time says. I need to know how to be complete. Time is incompletion. That's what it is. It'll never be complete. So just let time go. Don't try to solve the problems of time. Don't try to solve the neediness of time. Time is inherently needy, as it were. But what we are doesn't have any needs. Doesn't have any needs whatsoever. So you don't have to, again, people don't have to know you. This is how you think. This is what you're considering. Just build it into your practice. Build in your practice. Just try on the slide. I'm doing this. I'm not telling people I'm practicing this. Of course, they're going to say, what are you talking about? You know, these poor people, these awful things that have happened to them. How can you possibly say they don't need help and they're not needy and they, you know, this is not, that they never have, don't need help from anyone. Are you kidding? Et cetera, et cetera. But no matter what situation anyone is in, at any moment, they can say, hey, you know what? I don't need any help. In a situation where it feels like they need the most help possible, they say, I don't need any help. I've never needed any help. I am spirit. I am free. I am as God created me. And watch their life then turn into a miracle at that point, you see. And that's what has to happen in this world. Not that we have to, all right, does Christ for help need to be indulged? Or praying to a sky daddy, saying, yeah, sky daddy, you know, I need this, I want this, can you please help my needs? No, say, God, I don't have any needs. God, I admit, I accept that I don't have any needs whatsoever. I don't need any help whatsoever. I'm totally free of any need for any help. I'll never need any help. And God will say, ah, welcome home. Very good. That's great, because you're exactly as I created you. Now you're accepting you. You're accepting yourself as you really are. You're repenting. True repentance is to say, I don't need any help. So we have this incredible tradition on this planet of wrong prayer, of wrong orientation, of praying for help, of praying to have needs fulfilled. We don't have any needs. All the needs are just time, needs of time, which is to try to stall, delay, trying to delaying action between cause and effect, thinking that it's having some effect. It's not, it's just a hypothetical, imaginary scenario. What we are doesn't have any needs, doesn't need any help, is not in competition with time whatsoever. There's no competition between spirit and time. None. Between cause and effect, there's no competition. Time is just inventing it or imagining it, because we want to be prime creator. And that's where we think we have to forestall this effect of total mental chaos which arises from this desire to be prime creator. Like, instantaneously it arises like that. And we say, oh wait, there's a way to around this. We just will imagine time. And then we need time to somehow permanently be permanent between cause and effect. Some other reality, a separate reality between cause and effect called the kingdom of time. And we think we need to learn to love it. We need to learn to complete it. We need to learn to harmonize it. We need to fix it, to heal it, to all this stuff. No, we don't. We don't need to do anything with time. We can just let it go exactly as it is right now. We have nothing to do with time. We don't need time at all. We don't need time at all, because we don't need to choose the idea of being prime, wanting to be a prime creator. We don't need to choose that idea. We can choose another idea, exchange ideas. So hopefully this video is working. Taping it to straight to disk and then uploading it. Hopefully the audio is good. And the video. Because the content is good. I wasn't sure if I could do this video actually today. So I'm like, well, I don't know. But hopefully you get a sense of what's being said here, right? You get a sense of it and say, I see it. Maybe there's a glimmer of seeing it. I don't know. It's not an easy one for some people, probably. Some people are like, like what? Like my whole life, my whole existence has suddenly been called into question. No, time has been called into question. And of course, we think our whole existence is dependent on time, depending on finding a gap between cause and effect. No, that's not true. Our reality is dependent on us accepting what we are and not trying to change what we are, not trying to change reality. And we do that by saying, I don't have any needs. I don't need any help. See, we only need help trying to change reality. We don't need any help to accept reality as it is, do we? It already is as it is. So we don't need any help with that. Although, you can say we need help to accept the fact we don't need any help. Never have and never will. It's not that we get our needs met or something. We don't have any needs. So why do we have our needs met, as it were? Now, of course, because we have a body in the world and all this kind of stuff, the Holy Spirit understands that, and it will take care of anything that has to get met from a pragmatic standpoint of meeting with others who think they have needs. You know, you have to be in the world but not of it. I mean, associating with those who think they have needs and need help, but at the same time realizing you don't have any needs whatsoever, don't need any help at all. So you have to meet them here, and so you have need for clothing and some food and shelter and transportation and whatever, you know. So we'll see. But still, assert yourself. I don't need help with anything. I don't need any help with anything whatsoever. And then the Holy Spirit will support you bringing that message to the world, you see. But those are not your needs. You're not needs. Let the Holy Spirit be the one with the need, okay? Because God created the Holy Spirit specifically to deal with the situation. So let it understands the practical, pragmatic use of time and the need to do that. But we were not created to have any needs or to deal with this at all. So we just let the Holy Spirit take care of the life here. But we assert we don't have any needs. We don't need to be helped at all. We don't need to be helped at all. The Holy Spirit just helps everyone realize that we don't need to be helped at all, which requires right use of time, right use of mind, and etc. But that's not our problem. It's not our problem at all. We don't have any problems. Say, I don't have any problems. Tell yourself that. I don't have any problems. I don't have any needs. I don't need it to be helped in any way. I never will have any problems. I never will have any needs. I never will need any help in whatever way. And nothing needs any help. Nothing has any problem. Nothing has any needs. There's no such thing as needs, problems, or need for help whatsoever. Never have been, never will be. This is a statement of fact. Statement of fact. And real satsang is a statement of fact, actually. Time is, it's getting very late. All right, well, this is a pretty good one. We can wrap it up now. And just see how you feel tomorrow. See if you're, you know, get through the day. And keep trying it out. Keep trying it out, because these are the game changers. And we're in a game-changing time. May is the time when we need to change the game. Okay? It is a game. This May 2013 is the game-changing month. Believe me. And it's happening. It's happening. We're getting up to higher ground where we're able to assert the truth, which is the fundamental game changer that we need. All right. I don't have any needs. It's a game changer we need, which is being reminded that we don't have any needs. We don't need to be helped in any way at all. Never, never have any need to be helped at all. Never have any needs. We're perfect exactly as we were created. Always and forever. All right. Very great. That's it.